I decided to go in close. I'll do another one further out later on, because this is a really nice letter to engrave. And it's what I said, if the transfer don't really help you, it kind of helps you as a guide, but doesn't tell you how it should look. You have to refer back to the original font and kind of perceive how you do it with an ink pen. So I'm going to redo this bit, which would be, I did this a little bit too thick now looking, but that's a continuous line, so that's what I actually do. I mean, to be quite honest, doing that is just for the engravers, for my satisfaction, because it's so small, no one else is going to see it unless you look at it under a microscope. So. And now I'm going to lean, so sometimes you can, right, I'm going to lean now, so I'm leaning overhand to the right. And straightening up, I leaned a little bit too far there. You'll probably notice when you first start, you'll lean too far over and you'll make it all jagged. It's not too bad actually, but you'll make it all jagged or you'll slip out, but that's okay. Leaning over is kind of not, where will I do that? So now you can decide, I can engrave the font this from this direction or the other direction, and then you kind of, how you think it would be done with an ink pen, so it would come down this way. So all those things you see in books now, and they say do it from a certain order and do it in a direct, they're irrelevant now. If you're hand pushing, yes, but if you're using power and a laser transfer, you don't have to learn anything. You just choose the font that you like, and that's it. You just, you know, it speeds up the learning process, and you can get to engraving quicker. A coin does make it a little bit more difficult. If you're on a flat surface, this would come out a lot easier, because I'm actually adjusting the thickness of the line according to the bumps in the metal. So, slipping. Right, that last one wasn't very good, but quite nice. But. Oops. There's, I mean, when you use power, there's so many different ways you can engrave. Right, so that would be done. If you were, you know, a nice engraving, but you can neaten it up. So you can go back down. In fact, I'm not going to discuss it now. I'll discuss it another time, but there's so many different ways you can engrave a letter now, and you just make up your own mind. If it comes out nice, it comes out nice. But, right, let's just give it a bit of a signature. So that's light on the upstrokes, heavy on the downstrokes. That's how you do that. Cheers, everybody. Hope that helps. Bye.